हेलो, आई एम मोनिका वर्मा, एसोसिएट प्रोफेसर, डिपार्टमेंट ऑफ पॉलिटिकल साइंस, महर्षि दयानंद कॉलेज ऑफ मुंबई. टुडे आई एम गोइंग टू टॉक ऑन टॉपिक्स पब्लिक एंड प्राइवेट एडमिनिस्ट्रेशन, सिमिलैरिटीज एंड डिस्टिंक्शंस एंड सिग्निफिकेंस ऑफ पब्लिक एडमिनिस्ट्रेशन. दीज टॉपिक्स आर पार्ट ऑफ सेकेंड ईयर बैचलर ऑफ आर्ट्स पॉलिटिकल साइंस सिलेबस ऑफ मुंबई यूनिवर्सिटी. So let us begin. It is conventional in the discipline of public administration to compare and contrast public and private administration. Administration is essential in any type of organization. Administration refers to the process of running an organization, office or business. This includes making rules and regulations, making decisions, creating organization of staff or people to direct activities towards achieving a common goal or objective. Public administration includes all activities undertaken by the government at all levels, national, state, and local. In brief, public administration means the administration of government. Whereas private administration is the management and organization of private business enterprises. It also exists in non-government organizations. So as a cooperative group activity, administration is truly universal and operates in all types of public and private organizations. But there are thinkers like Paul Appleby, Herbert Simon, Peter Drucker, who believe that there are major differences between public and private administration in terms of scope, impact, and consideration. So now let us see what are the major distinctions between public and private administration. In terms of objectives, public administration aims at achieving state purposes, that is, public utilities, providing essential services to people. Whereas private administration aims at achieving goals of the private organization. In terms of orientation, public administration is bureaucratic and private administration is business-like. So what is bureaucracy? Bureaucracy is an organizational model which is found in government. In fact, government departments are organized on the basis of bureaucracy. Bureaucracy is a hierarchical structure where there are superior subordinate relationship. There is very strict division of authority and corresponding responsibility. There is strict adherence to rules and regulations. So system is rigid. Whereas in private administration, it is more flexible. In terms of nature, public administration is essentially political. It has political orientation. It is part of political process. Whereas private administration is non-political. Red tapeism is often cited as a major weakness of the bureaucratic model which exists in public administration. Whereas in private administration, it is believed that there is no red tapeism. Red tapeism basically is file system. In most of the government departments, files move from one table to another table. There is also strict adherence of rules and regulations. All these things result in the delay in the functioning. So it is considered as a weakness of the public administration. Coming to the scope of public administration and private administration, we find major difference. The scope of public administration is wide and very often monopolistic. For example, army, railways, a number of welfare activities. Whereas in private administration, the scope is mostly narrow. But here I must mention that in the post-liberalization period, taking example from India, in many of the essential services sector, which were earlier monopolistic, controlled by the government, are also opened up for the public administration. So public sector is also operating in many of the essential services, for example, power supply, for example, civil aviation, etc. The next point of difference is the financial control. Public administration is controlled by legislature. There is a strict financial control of legislature over public administration. Budget is presented, discussed, and approved in the parliament. Even after the budget is passed and the money is allocated to different departments, there is a system of audit by the Controller and Auditor General of India. So there is an external financial control in the functioning of the public administration. Coming to the private administration, the financial control is internal, audit system is also internal. Then there is uniformity of rules as far as public administration or the working of the public departments are concerned. Whereas there is no rigid uniformity of rules as far as the private administration is concerned. Then there is a next major point of difference is that public administration works under the political masters. Each government department is headed by a minister. This system is not prevalent in the private administration. In private administration, administration is responsible to the owners of that particular enterprise. In terms of motives, it is often said that public administration is public service oriented, whereas private administration is profit oriented or it aims at wealth creation. Well, it is a debatable point, because in the modern times we find even in private administration there's a concept of corporate social responsibility. A percentage of the profit every private sector is supposed to invest in the public welfare activities. Similarly, we also have a large number of NGOs which are non-profit making bodies. So whether the main motive for public administration is public service, it can be discussed and debated. Coming to the efficiency level, it is generally believed that there is a low level of efficiency as far as public administration is concerned, whereas private administration is more efficient, where work is done fast and more effectively. It is also cost effective. Again, here we notice that in the last few decades, many new concepts have been introduced. In the public sector also, there is a concept of good governance. Also, we have a practice now of digital governance or e-governance, which has definitely increased the efficiency of public administration. Lastly, we can see, in terms of deficit or surplus, most of the government departments are expenditure oriented, because administration involves expenditure. So budget is also deficit budget, whereas in private administration there is more income and there is surplus. So we can say these are the major distinctions between public administration and private administration. Now let us see what are the similarities between public and private administration. Thinkers like Henry Fayol, Arvik, Mary Fallet, etc., they are of the view that administration is an indivisible entity and its basic principles are applicable equally to all organizations, whether public or private. Methods and work procedures may be common in both. For example, accounting, statistics, office management procedures, personal practices like recruitment, training, etc. Similar type of hierarchy and management system prevail in both public and private sector. even the principles of democratic control, public accountability, and popular checks on administrative behavior are increasing in all private organizations. So we cannot say that public accountability is only applicable to the public sector, or there is democratic control over the public sector. We see, you know, there is judicial activism, then there is the role of media, which makes even private sector very, very accountable to people. Then there is a growing interaction between public and private sector, especially in the LPG era. With the introduction of economic reforms, or in the era of economic liberalization and privatization, we see there is an interaction and movement of personnel from public to private sector and from private sector to public sector. Let me give you an example. Mr. Nandan Nilekani, who was the managing director of Infosys, a very large private software company, he was invited to head the UID project, that is the Aadhaar project of Government of India, and he joined it and he was responsible for it. We often see there are many management practices of private sector are being adopted in the public administration to make the system more professional and efficient. In the era of liberalization, privatization, and globalization, both public and private administrations compete to provide efficient delivery of services to people or customers. So the distinction between public and private sector is definitely narrowing down. Talking about the significance of public administration, we all know that with the concept of welfare state and the expansion of the functions of the state, public administration has become a dominant factor in the modern life. Now there is an administrative state. Public administration is responsible for the preservation of polity. In fact, it is the basis of the government. Whether a government is efficient or not, it depends on the efficiency of the public administration of that particular country. It is also responsible for the institutionalization of social and economic changes in the country. Public administration is an instrument of providing services to people. All the functions of the government, to name few, maintenance of law and order, delivery of essential services, disaster management, situation like, you know, managing health crisis, health emergencies like pandemic, it is the responsibility of the administration to undertake and provide all these services. Thus, it is an instrument of implementing all the government policies. There are many government policies, welfare activities of the government, activities for the weaker section, poverty alleviation program. All these programs and policies are implemented by the public administration. And public administration is not just responsible for implementing policies, it also influences public policies. And this is a very, very significant role of public administration. Giving example from India, IAS officers who occupy high positions in departments, they are also advisors of the policy makers, and all the ministers depend on their civil servants when they are making any policy. So civil servants or public administration, it plays a very important role in policy formulation also. And lastly, we can say that it is a stabilizing force in society. Public administration is known as the permanent executive of the society. Whether it is a democratic government or it is a non-democratic government. Government come and go, but public administration is there to stay. See, always it gives it order, and also it gives stability in the society, which is a very, very important role of public administration. Now let us see the significance of public administration as an academic discipline. Public administration studies how and in what directions vast functions of government should be effectively performed. From the social science, from the social science perspective, administration is studied as a cooperative and social activity. Academic inquiry is done to understand the immediate and long-term effects of governmental action on the social structure, the economy, and polity. Within the discipline of public administration, new theories, concepts, model of administrations are studied to make the subject more relevant. In the recent times, theories like new public management theory, public choice theory, concepts of good governance, digital governance, all are developed to make the public administration more efficient and more effective. Thank you.